Welcome guys, this is lecture number 13. Background images are very important. Near about all the websites use background images. Background color. This allows us to add color to a background of the element. Background image property. This property allows us to add background image to an element if the size of the image is smaller. By default, it will be repeating both sides, x-axis and y-axis, so it will be cover all the area. Background image and text. Your combination of text and image must be appropriate. Look at this. Can you read it clearly? Your text must be readable on the image. Background image repeat. Repeat value. This is how the image will repeat. The value can be any of the following. This repeat on the both x and y axis and cover entire background of the element. Background image repeat x. This repeat the background on the x axis or horizontally. Repeat y. This repeat the background on the y axis or vertically. No repeat only displays the image at once. Background position property defines the position of the image. And shorthand property for background. Background blue is the color. If image is not found, then your background color is blue. No repeat bottom left. So let's implement all the properties one by one. Create a new file, background.html. You can also download this file. Link is given in the video description. You can also download the image. Link is given in the video description. These are the images. Okay. So let's start it. Look at the result. And by using universal selector, padding 0 and margin also 0. Okay, now select the body and background URL image. Here image is the folder name and background body background.jpg is the image name. Save it, color white. Look at the result. Okay. Now select the container ID. In background URL image container.jpg and save it with 1000 pixel margin 50 pixel auto. Save it. Now look at the result and padding also 50 pixel. Save it. Now select div tag and border one pixel solid black with 300 pixel height, also 300 pixel, and margin 30 pixel. Okay, so look at the result. Okay, now add one more property here. Background size and auto 100%. Save it. This property covers all the areas with no repeat background. If we repeat some image, they do not look perfectly. So look at here. Also change it. No repeat. Okay. Height. Auto and save it. So also add here no repeat, save it, and look at the result. So now add one more property, background size, auto 100%. Okay, now look at the result. So that's cool. Okay, now after this, select background 1. And background 1 is selected. So background property color is, let's suppose, light green, and image is image background 1. JPG. So save it. Now center, no repeat. So if I change it with the repeat X, so look at the result. Repeat Y and right. So look at the result. That's cool. What's wrong with it? Okay. Add semicolon here. Now select background 2, save it. Background 2 is selected, and URL image in background 2. So save it. Change the heading H2, save it. Color black, and padding let's suppose 50 pixel and 10 pixel. Okay, now select the background 3. And background URL image background 3 and save it. No repeat. So look at the effect here. If I add no repeat here. So change it with repeat X, repeat Y. So that's cool. And select the background 4. Background save it background URL image and background 4.jpg and background position. Center, save it. So add no repeat here, no repeat. So look at the result. You can also add color white. Look at this cool effect and thank you for watching this lecture. Please subscribe our channel. Have a nice day.